Welcome to the Fishing Musician's Fishing and Travel Adventures.
Welcome to the Fishing Musicians. My name is Glenn Ferguson, your host, and this week I had the pleasure of taking you to the west coast of Canada, Squamish, British Columbia, for some great chum salmon fishing. We're with our host guide, Kevin Kish, of Whistler Fishing Guides. Last week, we had you in Australia fishing with Didge, short for didgeridoo. A great musician, he was also a great angler and nice enough to bring us out fishing. We were near the Port Stevens region in Nelson Bay catching Pacific salmon. And we were doing a lot more than fishing on this trip as well. And on our way back, we stopped in Squamish to fish with Kevin Kish, our host guide. And if you like to see big fish being caught on a fly, this is definitely your show.
We're locked in a groove, so stay tuned with the Fishing Musicians. The Fishing Musicians is brought to you by
Capital Airways, Atlantic Canada's premier air charter service, and Ferguson Audio Productions, one of Atlantic Canada's finest video and audio post-production studios.
You're watching The Fishing Musicians.
We depart from Sydney, Australia, transfer in Auckland. From New Zealand across the Pacific Ocean, we move our watches back 12 hours and land in Vancouver. And isn't it cool how the planes actually fly in reverse when returning from Australia to Canada? And we are on the road to Squamish, BC. As part of Highway 99, the Sea to Sky Highway winds its way through the spectacular Coast Mountains, linking communities from West Vancouver to Whistler. And after a very cool and picturesque drive, we are in Squamish. It is only 45 minutes south of Whistler and only an hour and a half from Vancouver.
Welcome to the Fishing Musicians, folks. My name is Glenn Ferguson, your host, and welcome to Squamish, British Columbia. This is Kevin Kish from Whistler Fishing Guides. Kevin, thanks for having us here, man. This is one of my all-time favorite journeys that I've always wanted to come on. We just arrived, we've been on the plane for quite a long time right now, but we had to do some sightseeing before we even get locked away in our hotel room, getting ready for some fishing tomorrow morning. Tell us where we are, what is this spot? It's amazing.
Beautiful Shannon Falls. We're just outside of Squamish, British Columbia. We're at the base of a really big waterfall.
Now this waterfall, believe it or not, is probably quite a bit higher than Niagara Falls, eh? And you said there's a number of these around the province. Anywhere you go, you'd be likely to find some of these.
Whenever you're in the mountains, there's big waterfalls. We've got several around the area. I'm sure we'll see some from the boat tomorrow when we're fishing.
Awesome. Well, like we said, we're in Squamish, British Columbia, folks. And before we go fishing, why don't we show you around this great place. All around here, there's beauty like you wouldn't believe. You gotta come here.
This is a trip I've been waiting my whole life to take. I was born in Kelowna as my dad was a boat builder. So as young kids, my brothers and I spent a lot of time on the water. And even at that young age, I knew that the salmon was king in British Columbia. The chum salmon run up the Squamish River every October by the hundreds of thousands. They spawn and then they die. But in nature, nothing goes to waste. So the chum salmon play a crucial and essential role in maintaining the ecological balance within the river system.
Let's go, hotel.
Hotel. See the sky.
My name is Jeannie and I'd like to welcome you to the Sea to Sky Hotel. We are based in Garibaldi Highlands, BC. We are part of Squamish, BC. We are known as the Outdoor Recreation Capital of Canada. Our hotel boasts 52 rooms, all of which feature stunning mountain views. 8 of those rooms are suites. We are a family hotel. We're known for our friendly service. We also have 4 meeting rooms. The largest of those is the Sea to Sky Ballroom. We host weddings, conferences, meetings, a wide variety of events. We also have the Midway Restaurant. That's a family-styled restaurant. Children are always welcome. Wide variety of menu options, Friday night buffet, Sunday brunch. We have a cold beer and wine store, which offers a great selection of liqueurs, beer, and wines. We have the Birchwood Spa, which has a hot tub, sauna, fitness equipment, and laundry facilities for our guests. We are known for our warm hospitality.
Hey.
So Kevin, that's the Chief right there. That's one of the most famous climbing walls in
Western Canada anyways. It's a spot in the summertime where literally thousands of people come here to climb it. In October, with a lot of rain and everything else, it's pretty quiet, but during the summer months, it's extremely busy around here. We're actually down in the Squamish waterfront right now. We're gonna put our boat in the estuary in the salt water, and we're gonna run up the river. It's gonna be about a 20-minute run or 30-minute run up to where we're gonna be fishing.
British Columbia. Fishing musicians, Kevin. Kevin, while you're putting that in there, I know you're a little busy, but I'd like to say it a few times on the show. What's your website?
It's www.whistlerfishingguides.ca.
That's where you go, folks, to come to a place like this. He's got a lot of different areas to fish in. Right now, in this particular time, it's October, late October here in British Columbia, and this is the best spot to come in southern British Columbia anywhere. Close to Whistler. Whistler is probably, what, a half an hour away from here?
Pardon me?
Whistler is about a half an hour up the road.
About 45 minutes drive from Squamish. Yep. And we're centrally located to fish, well, I guess we fish 7 or 8 different rivers and literally hundreds of different lakes around the area. Right now, it just so happens that the best fishing is in Squamish, so that's why we're here. We're fishing for chum salmon today.
And even if you didn't catch any fish, the scenery is worth the money itself. I mean, this is just unbelievable.
And when the chum salmon run the Squamish River, many follow. Eagles, seals, and a host of other wildlife benefit from the plentiful numbers of chum salmon. In the Squamish area, you are nestled in the valley of the Pacific Mountains. There are 5 major fishable rivers with 3 more to the north of Whistler. There are many alpine lakes near Squamish. They are accessed by four-wheel drive and hold rainbow trout, cutthroat trout, and dolivar. Kevin Kish and his crew at the Whistler Fishing Guides provide a wicked, top-quality guided fishing experience. Kevin obviously knows this area like the back of his hand, and you know what? There is no end to the season. They run 365 a year, so you can come here anytime. The beauty is worth the money itself.
British Columbia, folks! We're in Squamish!
With Kevin Kish, and we are about to have some amazing fishing.
We're using very colorful streamer patterns today on good-sized salmon hooks, sort of one-aught hooks. Got a small bead on the head to get it down a little bit more. We're using a shooting head line, if you want to call it that. The actual dry line portion of it is very fat and thick. And at the end of this, we've got a loop-to-loop connection, and we have a sinking tip line on the end of it. The sinking tip line is 12 to 15 feet long, and it's got some density to it, so it sinks rather quickly. The key is get down to the bottom, get down quickly, and swing your line across where all the fish are, and that's what we're doing. Fish?
It's a fish, man. Doubleheader, welcome back to the Fishing Musicians, folks. My name is Glenn Ferguson. We're here in Squamish, British Columbia, with Kevin Kish of Whistler Fishing Guides. Kevin, this is an unbelievable spot here. I'm having a hard time casting and not getting fish. The problem is, folks, is that every time you cast, you might get one of these fish in the back, so we've got to be really careful and make sure that we don't foul hook them. We're not trying to, but there's just no way. There's just too many fish, man.
Just the sheer number of fish in the river, basically.
I'm gonna have giant mussels by the time this is over. Giant. See my technique here? Make sure you don't grab this reel, folks. If that thing wants to take off, it'll rip your fingers right off you. Because when these things get close to you, sometimes they don't even know they're hooked until you get a little closer, and then they'll make that run like that last one that I just lost. I don't know how many feet of backing that took me to a couple hundred yards anyway.
When we fish for salmon, we've got some salmon stocks that would travel 400 or 500 kilometers inland, and those are salmon stocks that we try not to fish for when they come that far inland. It's these fish where we're fishing 10 kilometers from the salt water, mm-hmm. where we can ethically fish for, play the fish, release the fish, and still have it in healthy shape and go out and spawn.
Yeah. And people watching, I know there's people watching and say, well, why don't you reel this fish in? Well, you come here and try reeling one of these in as quick as you can, and I can guarantee you your rod's going to snap or you're going to break the line, because it is not that easy. These are 25, 35, I don't know, what are the size fish?
I'd say big size 25. We have lots of fish in the 12 to 15 pound range.
Yeah.
That's sort of the average.
How am I going to bring this fish in? Much like this one, it hasn't moved. So I think this one's by the mouth. I don't know.
Oh, no, for sure it's in the mouth.
It's not moving. It's like, am I on a rock or what? And then it just starts moving a bit, so. Wow. This is definitely worth the trip, folks. Oh, he's off.
It's all right. It's part of the game. They've got a very hard palate and big teeth, and it's hard to set in there.
Welcome to the Fishing Musician's Fishing and Travel Adventures.
Oh, that's the sound you like to hear, eh, folks? Oh, yeah. Unbelievable. Nothing like catching a fish, a big fish on a fly. It took its big run there. Get some headway on this thing. I don't want it to take all my backing. Things out 100 yards. Ooh. Oh, there goes. Ooh. Holy moly. This is fishing, folks, man. Oh, man. They're everywhere. They're coming. Come on, buddy. This is a big, big fish, man. Oh!
Am I gonna have to get the boat chase that one?
Right here. Big. I don't know what it is. I think it's one of those whales that come up here. You sure you don't have whales that come up here? Oh no, it's gonna take me a month to reel this thing in. Oh no. Stop. Oh my good Lord, he's gotta stop sometime. Where is he going? He's going back out to the ocean, I think. Oh man. Oh, he's going this way now. I don't know where he's trying to go, but I gotta get him. He's just moving. Oh my jeez. Woohoo! This is exciting stuff, man. You gotta take a break after this. I'm gonna be pooped. That tip high. There's a lot of little boulders in there. You don't wanna get that wrapped up. He's coming back down. This is my chance. Gotta seize the opportunity when you get it. It starts moving this way. And you know, folks, we didn't have to fly in here. We didn't have to do anything. We drove right from Vancouver, and we're not far from downtown Squamish. And the highway to Whistler runs right through Squamish. If you've been through Whistler, or you've been to Whistler, if you've been to Whistler, you've driven through Squamish. So, God. Oh.
can land this puppy.
Okay, Kevin's gonna grab him down there. See that fish jump right on the other side of him? Kevin's gonna grab it. That is a big fish, man. Oh, look at the size of the mouth on that thing. Whoa! That's all I gotta say. You can't catch a fish if your line ain't in the water. Oh, yeah, baby! Woohoo!
Now this is a fish that's been in here a little bit longer and hence the little white patches on him, but still reasonably fresh and fought like the dickens.
Oh my, look at the size of that. Can I hold that, Kevin?
Yes, you can.
Actually, just a sec, give my arm a rest here. Oh my. Wow, what a fish.
Okay. Got tail?
Yeah. Uh-oh. Oh,
here,
my God.
Give me the rod.
Oh, folks, who says I can't catch fish? Well, I do a lot of times, but this is an incredible fish. Look at the teeth on that.
This is one with fully formed teeth. You can see the big canine teeth. You don't want to put your fingers in there.
No. Folks, you're fishing at Squamish, BC. You're with the fishing musicians. Let's put this buddy back. And you meet that special woman and you make more babies. You go on, okay? You ready to go? There he goes. Yeah! Woo! Kevin, thank you very much, man.
It's a shame the fishing's so bad here.
It's a shame, you know, I'm really disappointed with the scenery. First of all, the scenery is just...
And the fishing's terrible.
Fishing is absolutely ridiculous.
It was tough to drag you out.
We've been here probably an hour or so. We've hooked about 15 fish, brought into a couple, lost a couple. I'm disgusted. I'm going to eat.
I guess the eagles aren't the only thing around here that's bald.
That breeze off the mountains feels good in my hairs.
Glenn, you should put that hat back on. Sasquatch is gonna get you. That bald head's like a beacon.
Oh, that sun's coming out. What a beautiful day here. Holy jeez. Kevin's got a cranium on him the size of a football field. He looks like I do. A little cuter though.
We're locked in a groove. So stay tuned with the fishing musicians. You're now entering the cave.
Glenn, seriously, would you do some work? I've been working on this Squamish show all day. I need some music.
When do we go to Squamish?
Come on, seriously, I need a cave. I want to get out of here.
And you want me to write a song right here for that, right now?
How you doing, buddy?
Jimmy, you weren't there, buddy.
Give me a kiss, I'll turn into a beautiful woman for you.
I can't work under these conditions, I tell you that.
Free time or think music. Focus. Need music. Squamish.
What can I come up with?
I feel anger.
That's not gonna work. That's not gonna work. I need a shot of Squamish. Here we go.
I'm sitting here in Squamish, BC. Looking for a guy they call Jean-Guy. I know there's fish around this place. Oh, there's tons of chum salmon in Squamish, BC.
Here's a chorus, everybody.
I didn't see my Sasquatch in Squamish. Nor did I climb the Gritty Chief.
Chief's the thing they scale, the big famous rock.
I never ran down the hills of Whistler. But I shouldn't see some things out of unbelief. They were unbelief.
Everybody try the chorus.
I never saw my Sasquatch in Squamish. No, did I climb the creeping chief? I never went down the hills of Whistler. But I sure did see some things that are unbelief.
They were unbelief.
Let's go back to some fishing, because I don't know, man. This song is just a little weak today. But
and at the time, I did think it was weak. But now, overdubbing my voice and watching this song, I believe that it is one of the greatest compositions ever written on the planet Earth. And though the people at Squamish will not realize this and probably will never take this as their theme song, we believe deep in our hearts, from the east coast of Canada, that we have created the unofficial Squamish theme song. Ode to Squamish. And from the fishing musicians to you, I lend you this song. For 1 week.
Seems like every cast anyway, so let's bring this one up, Kev, and we can see what we've got here for fish. That's nice, a little fresher than the one I had. Nice fish. Beauty. I think you got the better of them now, so let's bring them up, show the folks at home.
So this is chum salmon or dog salmon. The sea lice usually sit along the base of the tail or just behind the dorsal fin. Doesn't have any sea lice on it, so probably been in the river a week or so. The teeth, which are starting to form on the top of the mouth where the fly is, are not quite as big as they will get. We'll probably get some with much larger teeth than that. This is maybe about 10 pounds or so. And on a scale of chum, this is a small one, as they go.
Is that that thing that smells like that? Smell that? Oh, I just farted, sorry.
Is that the way it's going to be today? Eh?
Wow, beautiful fish. Very minimal. That thing's ready to go, too. Look
at
it.
It's gone.
Cool. Excellent.
If you've just tuned in, we are in Squamish, British Columbia, and you are really late because the show is almost done. But hey, thanks for tuning in, and we'll show you one more little fish catch from Squamish, and then we gotta go back east.
I'll show you this one, folks.
Next week, we fly all the way back to Bathurst to catch a private plane to Roddington, Newfoundland, with our guest host, Mr. Jimmy Flynn. AKA Canada's ambassador to good cheer. He is the craziest Newfoundlander I've ever met.
We're going through the tickles.
The tickles?
You gotta see this one, folks. Tune in next week. That is a wrap for another show on the Fishing Musicians. My name is Glenn Ferguson, your host. Thanks so much for watching. Keep the peace, conserve our waters, and most of all, keep those dreams alive.